Your whole life is yajna. Your satya sankalpa matters. The time you spend in planet Earth is dana you give. Your body is the greatest weapon you carry. The time you spend in moving your body, using your body, is the dana you do. Your time, your treasure, your talent, all this can manifest something extraordinary which you never even imagine if conscious intention is added and if you cognize the possibility and powers of conscious intention. I tell you, I give you this one example. At some time, if my stomach is doing a strike, all I'll do is, hey, I am Paramashiva. This stomach is Jataragni of Paramashiva. Paramashivagni. Let me just sit unclutched. Add the Mahashabda. Shiva, 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 Shiva. To this fire of Paramashivagni. In few minutes, I'll see that tamatamatakatapata, some sound inside, the whole thing will settle down. Body will be completely fresh, alive, healed, active. The whole system, internal organ is healed. Understand? Even if you discover the power of conscious intention, in small things like healing your headache, stomach pain, ability to sit in Padmasana for a long time, even in the small actions, if you discover the power of your intention, you will have so much confidence on your conscious capabilities, possibilities and powers. That is all I am trying to inspire you today in this satsang. So whatever I said, the economic policies, all that is secondary. This is the primary focus. See, whenever I give satsangs, I put many things on record. Like today I put an important thing on record. The kind of a very beautiful relationship, coexistence, friendliness which was there between my various gurus helped me to assimilate all those sampradayas. This means I expect and request very cordial, loving, friendly coexistence in our Kailash also between the Vedanta teacher and yoga teacher, the teacher who teaches Sanskrit, the teacher who teaches integrity, authenticity, the teacher who teaches power manifestation. Between all of you, the sweet, powerful coexistence is needed for a child to grow conflict-free and assimilate everything. If there is a conflict between Ma Advait and Ma Pranapya, or the teachers who teach yoga or Pujacharya, that directly impacts, destroys the child. The coexistence all of them, all my gurus had, gave me tremendous respect, confidence, energy, intensity, positive experience about the knowledge they are carrying and those personalities that is too important for a child to grow and receive all the best things. The kind of the influence each of them had on me, if they tried to turn me against, even subtly against one guru, I would have lost that sampradaya. It is like a this single parent, divorced parents, when the children come to them for the weekend custody, how they slowly poison, the mother poisons about the father and father poisons about the mother, how much the child will suffer because of these two poisons and poisonings. You will not know how much the child will suffer because of the two poisoning. Mother poisoning about father and father's side family. Father poisoning about mother and mother's side family. The child will be broken. Not only heartbroken, even mentally broken. I had the great fortune of amazing, sweet coexistence of many of my gurus and acharyas. That gave me a great space for me to assimilate everything, enjoy everything, make myself rich in all the traditions.